Madam, the Kaveri issue is a very serious and a sensitive issue for the two states. Unfortunately, over the last few decades, certain political parties and most politicians on either sides have also used it to whip up passions on both states. And as a result, many a times the political maturity needed to solve this issue has generally been missing. Over the last, almost a century, because this is such a long, standing issue, there have been so many agreements made, some honored, some not honored, then some agreements during the British era, some that were revisited later after independence, then the Supreme Court order, then Prime Minister Modi comes to power, then makes, institutes the tribunal, then again revisits the Supreme Court order, and an additional allocation to Karnataka is made, because in the original order, it was, the Supreme Court also felt that the Karnataka share was not legitimately given. So now there are two, three interests here. Bengaluru as a city primarily depends on drinking water from the Kaveri. And then there is the competing rights in Tamil Nadu, that is primarily agricultural water.
Delta.
Oh, the Kaveri basin where, they grow paddy and the Kuruvai crops and all of that. So sometimes it is the competing rights of drinking water versus water for agricultural purpose. Then there is this whole issue of distress sharing. When the rains are in abundance, there is no issue. The issue comes up only in the drought years, because there is no clearly defined distress formula till today. And it is also difficult to clearly define a distress formula, because it's an ecological issue. So you cannot say that, in black and white, that this is how it must be. Because, some years the rainfall may be less, some years the rainfall may be low. But more or less, there is now some clarity in terms of an administrative mechanism.
But unless the political leadership don't come on the same page, it's not going to get resolved. Is that it?
One, I would agree that is one part of the solution. The other part of the solution is the Kaveri Basin. In Karnataka, where we also receive a lot of rainfall, whether it is in the Malnad, whether it is in Chikmagalur, whether it is in Kodagu, all of these areas. And also the whole cropping pattern in Mandya and Tamil Nadu. Because we are mostly growing
paddy
and sugarcane, which are both heavy water consuming crops.
Yeah.
And Bengaluru is growing, right? And we are also, seeing a water crisis, unprecedented water crisis in Bengaluru today. It's again primarily because the water that we get from Kaveri is pretty much at the same levels, while the demand of the borewells has increased. The load on the borewells have increased. So keeping this in mind, an ecological solution is what is needed than a political solution. So we need to, with great political maturity, try to convince our farmers on both sides, in Tamil Nadu as well as Karnataka, to perhaps review our cropping patterns and move towards more water efficient crops. One. But this again becomes a very political issue.
Yeah, telling in Mandya that don't have sugar cane.
No, so this again becomes a very difficult political issue, is why I'm saying that this needs great political maturity on both sides of the state. It needs statesmanship.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's very easy to, whip up parochial sentiments and say, I'm going to burn Tamil Nadu buses in Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu people will say that we are going to, boycott Karnataka products from Tamil Nadu. It's very easy to do this.
Yeah.
But if you actually look at the problem, it is not a political problem. It is an ecological problem that happens because of distress rain. And we have been seeing that over the last few years, because of deforestation in the Kaveri Basin, especially in districts like Chikmagalur and Madikeri, because you also know the plantation pattern there, from Arabica, people have largely moved to Robusta coffee and cleared all the large trees which were actually bringing a lot of rainfall.
Yeah.
And therefore, we are also seeing a decrease in rainfall in certain years. Then we are also seeing in Tamil Nadu that the area under cultivation has also been increased. What is, you know, given to given to the Supreme Court and mandated as to this must be the area, the area has also been increased. The cultivation area has also been increased.
I believe like literally 20% of paddy cultivation doesn't really happen now because there's no water. So without water, how do you do paddy?
Well, there are multiple arguments, right? But the point is, if you are going to go into all of these things without the statesmanship required, without the political maturity required to bring everybody on the same page, it is very easy to spark a fire.
I get that.
So I would feel that we need to focus our energies to arrive at an ecological solution so that there is abundance of rain. When there is abundance of rain, there is actually no
that
problem.
That would be the ideal solution, to have enough rain and to have enough reservoirs to store rainwater.
No, but also if, you know, but also even, even speaking even, like a political solution,
even if you have,
why is it that Siddaramaiah cannot pick up the phone, talk to Stalin and arrive at a political solution, whether it is Mekedatu, whether it is some other issue, I mean solution, why is that not possible? Stalin came here to Bengaluru a few months ago to discuss the, India Alliance political pact, people asked them whether they discussed Mekedatu, because, you know, Congress had taken a Mekedatu Padyatra here, but that never featured in the conversation. So, you know, it is either an eyewash, nor they have any conviction towards, you know, this issue. And this is simply being used to create a parochial sentiment that, you know, we are fighting for, you know, Karnataka, you are fighting for Tamil Nadu, and just to whip up regional sentiment.